What's up guys, here's Twitty, hope you're doing well. In today's video, we're going to try and build a 5,000 horsepower 5-liter V8. So this idea came along when I was watching a bunch of guys take a Gen 3 Coyote, I believe it is, making over 2,000 horsepower, wheel horsepower that is, and this particular video got me thinking, we have all the tools at our disposal here in automation to make our own version of this, but with a lot more power. So the displacement is exactly the same as the Gen 3 Coyote, also Gen 4 Coyote, I believe it's all the same displacement wise. The only thing we are using differently is we are using VVT instead of TI VCT. Now what that stands for is Twin Independent Variable Cam Timing. That's what that particular acronym stands for. And so that's the only thing that could make this a different style of engine if you really think about it, but so far everything is the same except we are using nitrometh of course, and our quality sliders are on plus 15. Now I do not know exactly how far our quality sliders need to be up there for it to be consistent with the real world stuff, so if you know that, please let me know down below. So as you can see there, we are busy messing with our turbo and increasing our boost of course. And what I'm going to be doing differently in this particular style of video is I'm going to move area to area to area till I have the desired power output. So we are busy with our compression and cam profile setup. We are going to do 8:1 compression ratio. None of the stuff is already being rattled to the infinity, so to speak. And we are adjusting our RPM rev limiter. I'm thinking around 9000 RPM or just under that would be good. So we're going to add a lot more boost now to 4000 horsepower where we are now when we're running into a bit of issues. So the issue I'm going to be having is that I can foresee is that we are going to run out of headroom on our piston. Well, piston's tolerance, how much torque it can handle. So that's pretty much the only thing that's going to keep me back from making a lot more power. And also the conrods as well, those things are severely stressed already, and we're at 5000 horsepower, so let's see where we can go with this, because this thing is not letting up very easily. So I think I'm gonna push a little more. Let's see if we can get 5200 horsepower of a 5-liter engine. That is mad. That is to the next level of mad. Can we go a little more? 9000, okay. That thing, now it's starting to explode again. But hey, it's all good. Power is always welcome. So can we add a little more compression? Yes, we can. Can we add more boost? Okay, yes we can, but it's to a point where our engine decides to self-destruct. So 5,200 horsepower is nothing to sneeze out of a 5-liter engine. Yes, it's not reliable, I know. Yes, it's not really accurate according to some people in real life, but you know, it's fine. I think we can go a little more power. 5,300 horsepower, can we get a little more? We increase our RPM limiter too much. We have explosions, so can we lower this a bit? No, we can't. So, can we go back here and adjust something? Yes, we can. So that's not really useful power band. I think 5,200 horsepower is a useful to a power band, so to speak. So we can go back here and try make a little more power, but I don't believe we can. So Friday's video is going to be a pretty interesting one because I'm going to explain the different setups on the rear housing for turbos, and that's going to be a longer form video, so stay tuned for that if you're really into that kind of stuff. So here's our beautiful engine, and we're gonna have it painted right there. Beautiful Ford color, blue with the carbon blue on the black. It always looks beautiful, as I always like to say this. Now I'm gonna do two pulls, one looking at the engine, one looking at the car. So let's see what this thing sounds like. Oh my goodness, this thing sounds absolutely insane. Thank you so much for watching. There you have it. This thing is beautiful. Do consider to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you wonderful people in the next video. Thank you guys. Bye bye.